Hey, and welcome to Ahrefs monthly product updates. We have 5 tool updates and 1 cross-tool update to share today. Let's start with Site Explorer. First up, we've got a brand new report called Opportunities. From updating pages for low-hanging fruit keywords and finding unlinked brand mentions, all the way to fixing critical technical issues, this report shows you SEO opportunities that can help you improve your website traffic and rankings. So far, we've added 10 opportunities, with more to come in future updates. So, stay tuned! Another feature we've added is the referring page author name to all backlink-related reports. We allow you to filter by author, export all authors, and even access them via API for enterprise accounts. This should be a massive time saver when doing link outreach. Moving on, we've added a column setting under the organic and paid keywords reports, so you can customize them to see just the data that's important to you. The last Site Explorer update is related to the paid pages report. Here, we've added nested tables so you can see all paid keywords for a landing page, as well as all ad copy variations. These were the final preparations made before sunsetting the legacy top landing pages report on the 21st of August. Moving on to Keywords Explorer. You can now change the default period for the search volume chart of your target keyword from last year to the last 2 years to all time. Use the toggler to spot search volume trends more easily at a single glance. Moving on to one cross-tool update. We've added Google Algorithm and Ahrefs update notes to the position history chart in both Site Explorer and Keywords Explorer. In return, you can cross-check whether or not they've affected your keyword rankings. Moving on to Site Audit. Firstly, you will be notified of changes that happen in your robots.txt file. Just go to the Page Source column, click on View Changes, and you'll see a comparison between the file's current and previous content. Secondly, we've added the interaction to next pane metric early on under the performance chart, which will officially replace first input delay as a new Core Web Vitals metric starting with March 2024. To find pages in your crawl with a poor INP score, go to Page Explorer, click on Columns, type in INP, then check all INP-related columns. Lastly, we've also added structured data validation against Google's guidelines, in addition to schema.org guidelines. This means we now cover almost all mandatory rules listed in Google's requirements for displaying rich results, like recipes, product carousels, local businesses, and so on. To help you better distinguish between schema and Google issues, we've introduced distinctive icons and filters for each type of issue. Moving on to Rank Tracker. We've added a new report that lets you analyze your Google Search Console property, the GSC Overview Report. With it, you're no longer bound by daily charts. Instead, you can see the distribution of clicks to impressions in this graph and CTR by position in this one. In addition, we've added something called clicks from anonymized queries. These are clicks hidden by Google to protect its users' privacy, which help you paint a more accurate picture of your actual clicks. I'll leave a link to our study on anonymized clicks in the description below. Scrolling down, you'll also be able to see a breakdown of your GSC performance by devices and study the click-through rate across ranking positions. And finally, we're down to Content Explorer. It's now possible to save any filters as presets and access them with one click. All top-level filters are supported, while created presets are saved per user and not shared across the workspace. And that's all for today. If you have any feature requests, you can leave them on our canny. See you in the next update and have a great day!